Hey everyone, Nick here. Today I wanted to talk to you about transforming traditional bar charts into something that might be a little bit more fun and engaging. So right here, for all my museum friends, if you are familiar with the Dimensions of the Visitor Experience checklist, that is a checklist or a questionnaire that was developed by a researcher named Jan Packer at the University of Queensland in Australia. And the instrument is basically just a one-page survey with 75 words or phrases that are representative of different types of experiences or affective emotional experiences that one might have in a place like a museum, a zoo, or aquarium. Now, visitors are asked to reflect on an experience and then select all of the items, all of the words or phrases that they believe they experienced during that particular visit or program, something like that. And then what we do to analyze that is each of those 75 words or phrases has been kind of grouped or factored into 15 different specific dimensions of the visitor experience. So each of those 15 dimensions includes up to 5 words. So when you analyze this, each dimension you can see right here on the slide, it's fascination, aesthetic appreciation, all the way down to tension. And each of those dimensions encompasses 5 different words. So a visitor could have selected none of the words that are involved in a dimension, and they could have selected all 5 of the words that are involved in the dimension. And the instrument is all randomized, so they're not grouped into these 15 different dimensions. The words are kind of just randomly sorted on the page. Now, in this case, sometimes you might just want to have a traditional bar chart that would tell you the average number of words that were selected within each organization, or within each dimension. But in this case, I've kind of created a little bit of an icon array, or kind of a pictochart, indicating the range of words at the top that could be selected from 0 to 5. And then we have this sort of gray box that indicates how many words are possible within each dimension. And then we have the blue box that gives you the mean number, the average number of words selected across your sample. So what I wanted to show you, and this is just kind of a mock-up slide that you might show in sort of a slide doc or a report. So you have placeholder text over there. We have a title for the dimensions of the visitor experience, and then we have the right half of the slide as a chart. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to get out of this PowerPoint slide, and I want to show you how we can make this chart from scratch. So I'm going to go ahead and insert a new slide. And what I'm actually just going to show you how to make the chart here. We're not going to make the entire slide. You'll be able to design your slide on your own however you like it. So I'm going to go ahead in this placeholder with a chart, and I want to first kind of bring over what the data look like in Excel. So in Excel, the data are going to look like this. You have all of your dimensions here, and then you have the mean score that would be 0 through 5 over here. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually copy this data, because we're going to insert it into PowerPoint. So Control C, and that puts the data on the clipboard. We're going to go over here to our PowerPoint slide. I'm going to zoom in just a little bit so you can see. We're going to go ahead and click on the chart icon to insert a chart. We're going to go to the bar chart feature here. And remember, when I click on this, it's going to give me that sort of the dummy data that it associates with this chart type here. And what I'm going to do now is just go over here and push Control V to paste the data that I've already copied from my Excel document. And then right here, we are going to just get rid of column D. We don't need that. So I'm going to delete that. Now you can see that I have another series here, this yellow series, that we may not need if I just wanted to create this bar chart. But what I think I want to do is actually create a different version of that bar chart for the pictograph to have that gray border. So I need to have a second series that indicates sort of that gray box that I had before. So what I'm going to do for this is I'm going to have the same value all the way down, and this is going to be just 5, because that's my maximum score for each of these for each of these dimensions. So I'm going to go ahead and click on 5, and then we're going to go and just drag this all the way down. So now I have a chart like this. I'm going to get rid of this title, and now let's make some aesthetic tweaks to our chart. So I'm going to get rid of the legend. We don't need that. I'm going to go ahead and make our font nice and bold. We're just going to make these fonts, or the font color black so people can see them. Now, right now, this is the x-axis here goes from 0 to 6. We know that it just needs to go to 5, so I'm going to go here to the format axis menu and then click on the eye chart. The bar chart icon, and then we're going to say maximum axis value 5.0. And so our major unit we want to just be 1.0. And then you can see this. Let's go to the number column here. I'm going to say 0. We don't really need any decimals on these. And then look at the tick marks. Usually we're gonna get rid of the tick marks, but in this case, I think they're kind of in a design feature for this chart type that I wanna create. So I'm gonna go ahead and click on outside end for the tick marks. And then let's make sure that our line is not yellow. Our line is, we should update to kind of this value of gray, and I think that'll look nice here. Good, so you can see now I have this faint axis line there. We don't need the axis line here along the Y, so I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that. And then we don't need these grid lines, so I'm going to go ahead and click on the grid lines, these vertical grid lines, and then we're going to just delete. Now what I want to do is I want to actually put my X-axis above at the very top. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the y-axis here on the labels, go to the format axis tab, and we're going to click on categories in reverse order. Perfect. So now that looks nice. And then I don't need a line here on my y-axis. I think, did we already do that? All right, no line. So that's perfect. Okay. So now I still have this weird clustered bar chart with the yellow bars all the way to 5, and then my green bars are my actual mean values for the words. So one option I could do is just kind of make this a bar chart with kind of a buffer zone. And what I mean by that, I'll show you right now. Instead of the yellow, let's make this a gray color. Perfect. It's nice and gray there. And then what I'm going to do now, since this is a clustered 2D bar chart, kind of a side-by-side bar, or one bar on top of the other, we're going to go to the bar chart icon on the format data series. And right here under series overlap, it says 0%. Let's make this overlap 100% so that these go on top of each other. And you can see that the gray is now on top of the green. We actually want it in reverse. So in order to do that, all we have to do is go to the chart design tab here, click on select data. This is going to open the data source and give you the select data source menu. Series 1 and series 2, series 1 are our average values. Series 2 are the gray buffer values. So series 1, I'm just going to put this little arrow down. I'm going to say move down one level. Whatever series is on the bottom is going to show up on top of your chart. So let's click OK, and now you'll see the green bars have reappeared. So now what I'm going to do is let's reduce the gap width. So I'm going to go ahead and click on any of the bars here. Gap width is 182. Let's just reduce this to 50%. That looks much nicer. Excellent. So if this was this is actually a really nice way to sort of do this. We could also recolor the bars here. Let's see. I want to make it this like blue that I had before. I think that's pretty nice. And so if we wanted to do some labels, we could add the data labels like this, maybe keep them inside or outside. It looks like that 0.10, there's not very many words selected in that tension dimension, so that's not very large. And so if we put the data value inside the bar, it might not fit. So let's just keep it outside the bar like this. This is one perfectly nice and valid way to sort of present these kinds of data. But let's go ahead and do that icon array now. So I'm gonna actually duplicate this slide. And so what I need to do is once I've done this, I'm actually going to, let's zoom back just a little bit more so you can see the whole thing. What we're going to do is now we're going to insert two icons. And I'm going to do that from the Insert tab, Insert, and then click on the Icon tab. You can't insert a rectangle. You have to insert an image or a vector graphic. So I'm going to go ahead and type in square. And you get an open square and a closed square. I'm going to go ahead and insert the closed square. And that's going to insert this on my slide right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to color this, change the fill color from black to that blue. And I'm going to duplicate this icon so we have another one. And we're going to make this the color gray of this gray buffer zone right here. So this, I think, is right there. That looks nice. Okay, so now I have two squares. And now what we need to do is fill each of these bars with these squares. And we're going to do that in a couple different ways. So the first way we have to do is click on the or select the average series of data, this blue bars. We're going to go over here to the paint bucket on the format data series tab, and we're going to click on picture fill. But what we first need to do, sorry about this, I'm going to go backwards one. What we first need to do is put our blue square, whatever we want to fill this bar with, on our clipboard. And so to do that, we're going to copy this square image. So that's going to be Control C. Perfect. And now we're going to click on the bar, the series, the bars, the series of data. We're going to go to the Format, Data Series menu, Paint Bucket, Picture and Texture Fill, and then from clipboard. We're going to say from clipboard because we have that, we have already copied that icon image there. So I'm going to say from clipboard, click there. And now it gives you this weird stretched square kind of icon there. But what I want to do is make sure that under this menu here, it says stretch. You could stack it, or you could say stack stack and scale width. And I'm going to say stack and scale width, and make sure that the units here is set to 1, because my units on my x-axis is 1. The value here is 1. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So keep on that. Stack and scale width 1, we're going to say. Make sure that's 1. And then we're going to do the same thing, but with the gray section as well. And now I'm going to use the gray square. So I'm going to highlight the gray icon square, push Control C to copy it and put it on my clipboard. We're going to highlight the long buffer gray zone right here, go to the fill bucket, picture or texture fill, and then from clipboard, and then make sure it's stack and scale with 1. Perfect. So now you see that we have this really nice kind of icon array showing that under fascination, our mean average, or the average number of words that was selected across our entire survey sample was 1.75, so almost 2 words there. Now, this dimensions of the visitor experience checklist, it's pretty rare for an experience to have more than 3 or 4 of those words selected within each of the dimensions. So if, in fact, one of these dimensions did have more than sort of 2 or 3 words selected, that would be a really strong indication of an experience that a visitor had or a guest had within that dimension. Now, I don't really like the way these labels are, so what I'm going to do is just delete them. If you wanted to have data labels associated with these things, we could put it all the way here at the end. And let's actually just highlight the gray buffer zone. This is the gray buffer zone of data. I'm going to go ahead and then right click and say add data labels. And now you can see right here on the very end, they have all 5s, because remember that series of data goes all the way to from 0 to 5 across all of these dimensions. So what I'm going to do now is I'm actually going to instead of the values for that buffer zone, we're going to change where these value numbers are pointed to. So highlight those data labels, go over to the Format Data Label tab here with the bar chart icon. You can see that the value right here is selected. We actually want to say value from cells. So then when we do that, it's going to open the source data, and now we can point to the different cells that we want those labels to point to, and I want them to be from that average or mean data column right here. Perfect. So I'm going to say OK, and then we're going to close out, and now you can see those data labels are now associated with the mean score right here in blue. So let's go ahead and format them so that they are blue and then bold. That looks nice. Now right here, it's kind of, it's a little bit strange. They're always going to be underneath this bar. What we could do is let's play with the plot area just a little bit. When you highlight the chart, you can go up here to Format Chart Area, drop down menu, plot area, and now this is going to highlight the plot area, and I could move this in just a little bit, and that puts the labels just a little bit outside of that plot area, and that's pretty nice. And now what I might do, if I want these labels to be a little bit further over to the right, is I could one by one move them over. That would be pretty tedious. But what another thing I could do is play with the margins inside the text boxes here, the label boxes. So Format Data Label Series menu is open. We're going to go to the Scale Size and Properties icon right here. And if you go down here, you can say, you can see that they have the margin value. So 0.04 inches is the margin, the left margin for these boxes. If I increase that, you'll see that the text will actually start pushing over to the right. And that may be a little bit more of what I want. And then if I wanted to do that even more, I could do that, move that a little bit. And even if I wanted to sort of draw some attention to that column, I could maybe insert a text box, and maybe we could just call this the mean score or something like that. So we would just say that, or mean selection. It's not really score, I wouldn't say. It's like mean selection, number of words. Oops. And let's just make the font a little bit smaller. I'm going to center it. We'll make it blue. And you could put it over that word like this. Let's just move this up. And it's not quite centered, so maybe we'll try to move those labels over just a little bit, nudge them over. And I think that looks pretty good right there. So let's go ahead and move our boxes off to the side, or we could just delete them. We don't need them anymore. And I'm going to keep that box right there. If you wanted to group the entire thing, highlight the chart and that text box. And I'm going to right click and then group. Oh, though I guess they won't group. I wonder if they can't group because it's a text box. Sometimes text boxes won't group with other PowerPoint objects. So that might be the case here with a chart, but that's okay. So once we do that, let's go ahead and in slideshow mode and just look at how beautiful that sort of icon array chart is. Now there is kind of a limitation that you see down here. Tension doesn't really have any blue selected, and the reason that is because it's just so tiny. There's just such a tiny little bit in that data series that we're not seeing it because the picture that we chose to fill it with, that icon square, kind of starts a little bit over. So it's not showing you the entire thing, but it's also kind of, it might be okay because it's just sort of down here an indication. You can see that it's just 0.10. So, in general, people really didn't select any words within that tension dimension. So that might just be something that you want to be mindful of and keep. Like if you could see, if you want to edit this data, you could just right click the chart, click on edit data, and then let's go to that tension dimension and adjust the number just so that you can see what happens when it if we adjust it. So if we adjust it to say 0.25 and then push enter, now you can see some of that start to appear. And let's just go ahead and say this was a really bad experience, and let's just say 5.0, say that these visitors selected, every single visitor selected every single word within this dimension, and then you can see that on the chart that updates too. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So a mean selection of 5, an average selection of 5 words within that dimension. So you can kind of play with that as you do, as your data may change or as you collect new data for different experiences, programs, or exhibits at your museum, your zoo, your aquarium, anything like that. So I hope that you liked this video. If you do, please subscribe to my channel and definitely hit the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a data design tutorial in PowerPoint, Word, or Excel. Remember, you don't have to be a professional designer to look like one using the software that you already have access to. I had a wonderful time making this for you. I hope you all have a great day, and I will see you next time.